Did the Pokemon Company hint it towards a Galarian form for Hoothoot? What is up, guys? I'm Daddy Gamer Fred, and today we're going to be diving into the discussion of whether Hoothoot got hinted at of having a Galarian form in the latest Japanese Pokemon Sword and Shield trailer. Now, guys, if you like Pokemon videos like this, be sure to hit that subscribe button. I do videos like this daily, and I am on the road to 1K. And again, if you enjoy videos like this, videos, discussions like this, please help me out. Also, write back your feedback in the comment section below, your thoughts about the topic that we're going to go over in the comments. As you guys know, I answer all comments. So let's jump right into it. Now, this was revealed in the Japanese Sword and Shield trailer, where we saw the Pokéjobs. The Pokéjob system, where you can send your Pokemon that are living in the box out to jobs where they can get experience, get rare items and shit like that, bring it back home to you. That's all cool. One of the places they showed that you could send your Pokemon on a job to is a Pokemon library. That library was also shown off, like the outside of the library, and then we get to see on the library's, you know, banner and their like post stand, you get to see a Hoothoot used as an icon, like a logo or whatever. And on that Hoothoot has a book on its head, and it looks like it's holding a magic wand. And immediately fans pointed that out and was like, hey, this is not the Gen 2 Hoothoot we all know and love. You know, this is not the one from Johto. This is clearly a pointing towards a, you know, Galarian form of Hoothoot. I would say, it could be. It's not out of the ordinary for Pokemon to be hinted at in trailers and to be revealed later. Also, it's not out of the ordinary for a Pokemon to be as weird as a Pokemon with a book on his head and holding a magic wand. I mean, we have keys, we have chandeliers, we have sandcastles. Who knows? We could have an owl with a book on his head holding a magic wand. Doesn't sound too crazy. But what does kind of muddle the waters and make it kind of weird is that we've seen Hoothoot already inside of Pokemon Sword and Shield. In the first reveal trailer of Pokemon Sword and Shield, one of the Pokemon that was featured in the battle was Hoothoot, and it looked like it's regular Gen 2 Hoothoot, and it, you know, it's kind of weird. It's kind of weird because in that trailer as well, like from what we all seen inside of Pokemon Sword and Shield right now, they haven't shown off Weezing and they haven't shown off the regular Zigzagoon, and those two Pokemon particularly got Galarian forms, Zigzagoon and the Weezing. So to me, if they are going to have a Galarian form for Hoothoot, why would they showcase the original one? Now mind you, in the past, like Pokemon Ultra Sun, Ultra Moon, and Sun and Moon, when they do have alternate forms of the Pokemon, the other forms are not locked out of the game. They do appear in the game somehow, whatever, you could bring them in. They do make the appearance in the game if you wanted to by bringing them in from the other versions of the game. And Pokemon Let's Go Pikachu and Let's Go Eevee, it was the same case. If you wanted the Alolan versions of the game, you can either trade with people in game to grab them, or you can bring them in from Pokemon Go. So who's to say that, you know, Galarian Hoothoot is in the game, is catchable, and if you want the regular Hoothoot, you have to bring over Hoothoot from Pokemon Home. But to me, it's like, why would you showcase that again in the first trailer? Who knows? Maybe that was just in a battle early on in the game. That Pokemon trainer uses a weak Hoothoot that is not from that region, and they want to kind of showcase that to you early on in the game, that you can potentially fight Pokemon that are not found in the game or not found in that game's region that you have to bring over. But to me, I'm like, it's just like a missing piece that we don't know right now of why they show Hoothoot in that first trailer if it was to be getting a Galarian form later on down the line in another trailer or whatever. So to me, I'm like, the marketing doesn't match up. If I was working on the marketing materials and I knew, probably the person that is working on the marketing didn't know, but if I was working on the marketing materials and cutting that trailer, I would not use the OG Hoothoot in a shot if I knew an upcoming trailer was going to highlight the Galarian form of Hoothoot. So to me, it's a no. Also, this was posted up on a Pokemon French website, supposedly, and then was immediately taken down. Is the render of Hoothoot what it looks like in-game? No. Again, this is fan art of what they depicting the Hoothoot would look like. I don't think the Hoohoo, if it was to get a Galarian form, would look like this. And again, this art doesn't match up to how the art is presented inside of the Pokemon Sword and Shield website with the Galarian Weezing and the Galarian Zigzagoon and that family. The art doesn't completely match the same art style and match the same way that was showcased. So to me, it's fake. But to sum up everything, I do think that there is a chance that, yeah, we could get a Galarian form of Hoothoot. Do I think it's going to have a book on his head and holding a magic wand? No. What I would most likely put my money on is that the person that owns the library has a Hoothoot, and they, you know, it represents the fact that they love books and they love their Hoothoot, and they wanted to combine it somehow. They made a logo that has Hoothoot with a book in his head and a magic wand or whatever the case may be. I don't know. I want to talk to you with you guys. What do you guys think? Do you guys think we're going to get a Galarian form of Hoothoot inside Pokemon Sword and Shield? Let me know in the comment section below. As you guys know, I answer and reply to all comments. So let's chat it down there. Also, leave a like in the video if you enjoy the video. It does help me out a ton as far as getting the video into recommended and getting the channel shared more and stuff like that. I'm going to be banging out a ton of videos. I'm on the super grind trying to hit 1K on YouTube. So again, if you're not subscribed, hit that subscribe button. It definitely helps me out a ton. And again, I do videos like this daily. So if you want a Pokemon discussion video to pop up on your YouTube every day, hit that subscribe button. Let's chat it out in the comment section below. Peace. I love you guys. I'm gonna see you guys in the comments, and also see you on the next one. Like always, guys, I'm Daddy Gamer Fred on Instagram and Twitter, and you guys can bring the conversation there. I'm the American Gamer in Switzerland right here on YouTube, and yes, I'm going to be doing a ton of videos just like this one. So if you enjoy, please hit that subscribe button. Also, hit the like button. It does help me out a ton as far as growing the channel is concerned. Ring the bell if you want to be notified on the next time I drop a video. Peace. I'm going to see you guys on the next one.